What would happen if you read and reread the same book every day for 2 weeks? And what if it was a book all about beauty tips from the 80s? That's the idea of a hilarious episode of the Pack Podcast starring Steven Weber, who's with me now. Steven, good to see you. How are you?
I'm surprisingly good.
Good. Yeah. Okay, that's good. I'm glad to hear that. You know, kind of, I was listening to this podcast. At first I was like, oh, poor Jacqueline Smith. She was my favorite angel.
Poor Jacqueline Smith, no. I give her voice. I amplify her voice. It's a wild book. Well, first of all, Eugene Pack is this amazing and incredibly prolific writer. He's got this thing called the Pack Podcast.
Yeah.
And which are all these short comedies written by Eugene, who also created this thing called Celebrity Autobiography. So this particular story, I play a guy who is stuck quarantined with Jacqueline Smith's autobiography, and he's there for so long and he's read it so much that he can't help but channel her every time you ask him a question. It's pretty funny.
It's hysterical. It's hysterical.
Pamela Adlon is in it, who's fantastic.
Yeah.
And Lewis Black. Yeah. And of course Molly Shannon. So that's in itself, it's ridiculous. It's so fun and great.
Such an amazing cast, so much fun. It really was so much fun to listen to. What is the recording process like for this? Are you guys all together doing it, or you do it all separately?
It's not unlike this. I mean, we all have our various corners that we think look, you know, clean enough, like you with your nice guest area there, your background. With
yeah.
The plants, the useless plastic plants. I mean, let's explore.
No, they're real.
Are they real?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're real plants.
They look so good that they look fake.
Oh my God, I have sprays for them and everything. We have so many plants in this house. It's ridiculous.
It's a little much.
A little much. Well, you're also going to be part of this benefit hosted by Joy Behar. You're doing a comedy piece that she wrote, right?
Joy, because she doesn't do enough things already,
right.
Decided to write plays. And not just decided to write plays. Clearly, she has written her own material. She's a performer and she's very worldly.
Yeah.
And hilarious. A lot of cool, great people who are equally desperate to work.
Yeah.
which really comes through.
Well, I look forward to seeing that. But you also were able to do another project during this time, during the pandemic, and that was Netflix's Social Distance. And you got to do it with your son. What was that whole experience like? Tell me about it. Because it's like you were kind of your own camera crew, audio, craft services, everything, right?
Definitely craft services. Definitely. In fact, I do craft services at my house, even when there's no cameras around.
Yeah.
It's a really kind of a beautiful project. And again, all done like a Zoom call. And both my sons actually were in the background.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so it was really sweet. But also I got to work with one of my new favorite actors, a fellow named Mike Coulter, who I love from the show Luke Cage. And I was watching Luke Cage and loving that show because I'm a big Marvel idiot. And there he was. I was like, I was so excited. I worked with Luke Cage. And of course, he's a regular guy. He's big and muscly, but he's a...
Yeah. Well, listen, so it is like it's the 30th anniversary of Wings. Can you believe that? Because I can't believe that.
No, I can't believe it. Thanks for bringing it up. Yeah, 30
years. No, but thanks for bringing it up. Yeah, but you know what? It's still a fan favorite because of streamers. Yeah. Have you ever gone back and kind of revisited it, watched it at all?
I have. And part of the reason is because... surprisingly and pleasingly, it has not gone forgotten, and nor has it been relegated to the older generation or my generation. I know plenty of younger people who've watched it, probably because their parents watched it.
Yeah.
It was the comedy equivalent of comfort food in a way. That wasn't bland necessarily, but it wasn't so spicy that you can't sleep.
With all the reboots popping up here and there, where do you think that Brian and Joe would be now?
Yeah, well, I mean, we probably have to go a little darker and because audiences are a little more sophisticated and they've been exposed to darkness too over the years. So I think probably Brian might have actually straightened his act out and would have his womanizing and playing around would have fallen away, while I think maybe Joe probably would have encountered some darkness, maybe gotten divorced. You know.
Yeah, maybe a nervous breakdown.
Absolute nervous breakdown from being too neat.
Yes.
So I don't know, but people ask me all the time about a Wings reboot. if it were up to me, we'd have been doing it already. But
yeah,
if there's anybody out there in this wide audience that is watching this, who has any juice, make it happen.
We're going to bring back wings. And you can head to thepackpodcast.org to hear Stephen's episode. It really was so much fun to listen to and so much fun to catch up with you today, Stephen. Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you so much. Good luck, everybody. Stay safe. Wear a mask.
That's right. Keep your mask on.